Namaste, my dear children. You all are welcome to grade 6 max class, chapter 5 statistics. Tell me, children, what is statistics? Can anyone say what is statistics? Right. Statistics is the study of collection, analysis, interpretation, presentation, and organization of data. Today our topic is bar graph. Learning objectives. Children will able to define a bar graph, draw a bar graph for a given situation, interpret the data of a bar graph. Introduction. What is a bar graph? A bar graph is the mathematical representation of a given data. There are two types of bar graph. They are vertical bar graph and the horizontal bar graph. See, the first one is the horizontal bar graph and the second one is the vertical bar graph. Horizontal bar graph pathina the bars ellame ungalku sleeping line la irukum. Vertical bar graph la the bars ellame ungalku standing line la irukum. Okay, my dear children, now we are going to draw a bar graph. Before that, I will tell you how to draw a bar graph in 6 easy steps. The first step, draw x and y axis. First, you have to draw a horizontal line, name it as x-axis. Then you have to draw a vertical line, name it as a y-axis. The second one, give a suitable title for the given question. The third one, categories you have to be marked in the x-axis. Categories like items, objects, everything you have to mark in the x-axis. Numbers. Always you have to mark the numbers in the y-axis for the vertical bar graph. Scale. Then you have to mark the scale for the y-axis. Then each bar should have equal width and space. Now we are going to draw the bar graph. Now we are going to draw this bar graph step by step. The first step, you have to draw the horizontal line and then mark it as x. Then draw the vertical line and mark it as y. Step 1 over. Okay, and then step 2. What is our step 2? You have to give a suitable title to this bar graph. Here, my title is sales of mobiles in a week. And then step 2 is also over. And then step 3. Now I am going to mark the categories and the numbers. Now I am the categories you numbers you mark panika poran. So periodic categories la enna la irukku, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So adha na inga mark panika poran. So nammudaiya bar graph should be have equal width. So na equal space width I am marking. So in the space la I am going to write Sunday. And then one space I am leaving. Then the next place I am writing Monday. The next I am writing Tuesday. The next I am writing Wednesday. The next I am writing Thursday. The next I am writing Friday. And the last one is Saturday. Now I am going to mark the numbers on the y-axis. Y-axis la ipa numbers ah na mark panna poren. Before I am marking, I am going to see the range of the marks. In the marks la minimum range evlo irukku check pandra 20, the maximum range is 55. So I decided to mark as 10 10 10 10. Na na ipo mark panikka poren. So both the lines meet at a point. I am going to mark as 0 and then the next one is 10, the next bar is 20, the next 30, the next one 40, the next one 50, the next one 60, the next one 70. So I have only maximum 55. I marked up to 70. Okay. Now I am ready to draw the bar graph. Okay. Sunday, the number of mobiles sold is 50. So Sunday, here 50. You have to draw this bar graph. Right? Yes. Monday, the number of mobiles sold is 45. See, here we are having 40, 50. Where the 45 lies? The 45 lies between the 40 and 50. 45, 40 ko, 50 ko, middle varo. So, 45. Here you see, this is 40 and this is 50. And the 45 lies between 40 and 50. Okay, the next Tuesday, the number of mobiles sold is 40. So here the 40. Okay, the next Wednesday, the number of mobiles sold is 20. Wednesday, how many mobiles sold? 20. So here is the 20. So draw the bar. Like that, you have to complete the remaining days. The remaining days you have to draw and complete. And then you have to write the numbers on the top of the bar. Here the Sunday is 50 and Monday is 45. Tuesday is 40. Wednesday 20. Thursday 35. Friday 30 and Saturday 55. Okay. Yes. Everything over. One more thing. You have to write the scale. Scale you have to write from the y axis. Scale and y axis. Here 1 unit. The Wopper box is 1 unit. 1 unit is equal to 10 mobiles. Number 10 adha na mark panirukom. So 1 unit is equal to 10 mobiles. Okay, my dear children. See, this is a vertical bar graph. Idu vandu vertical bar graph. Ena bar graph, the bars ellame pathina ungalku. If you want to draw a horizontal graph na, it's very simple. You have to interchange these two. The numbers want to write it on the x axis and the categories you have to mark it on the y axis. Then you will get the horizontal bar graph. Okay, my dear children, interpreting the bar graph. Study the above bar graph and answer the following questions. See, here one bar graph is given. You have to observe the bar graph and then you have to answer the questions. See what and all given in the bar graph. One title is given. Sunday activities of students. And scale is given. 1 unit is equal to 2 students. Then they are given the activities are reading comics, solving puzzles, reading novels, reading stories, studying subject. Okay? Yes. This and all given. We saw the scale is also 1 unit is equal to 2 students. Like that they marked. Okay. Now we are going to answer the question. which activity is followed by maximum number of students. So, எந்த activity maximum number of students பண்ணிருக்காங்க? See, easily we can identify. What is this children? Reading stories. Reading stories in the activity தான் இந்த bar பார்த்தாலே உங்களுக்கு தெரியும் கொஞ்சம் ஹையாக இருக்கு. So, reading stories தான் maximum number of students பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. Okay? Yes, reading. How many in கேட்டாதா you have to write எவ்வளோ நம்பர்னு. Just they are asking what activity is followed by maximum number of students is nothing but reading stories. Okay, first question over. The second one. How many students in all spend their time on solving puzzles? So, solving puzzles la, how many students is there? அப்படின்னு கேட்டிருக்காங்க. Just we are going to see. It is between 6 and 8. So, how many students or spend their time on solving puzzles? Between 6 and 8, what is the number? 7. So, 7 students spend their time to work out the solving puzzles. Okay? Yes. The next question. The total number of students who follow either reading stories or reading their subject is dash. So, reading stories, yellow members? Is 8. And then reading subject, how many students? 4. What is the total reading stories and then reading subject? 8 plus 4 is nothing but 12. The next one, the activity followed by minimum number of students is dash. So in the activity liye minimum number of students in the activity pannirukanga studying subject. Easily we can see this is very less studying subject. Then the last one, the number of students who took part in reading comics is dash. Reading comics la evlo number of students participate pannirukanga? It is between 4 and 6. It's nothing but 5. So 5 students spend their time on reading comics. Okay children, that's all children. Be good, be safe, keep learning. Thank you.